Not very long ago, it was hard to know how to become a surgeon. Thankfully, those days are gone, and the Royal Australasian College of Surgeons, RACS, recognises that diversity, in all its dimensions, strengthens the profession of surgery. The college has made a special commitment as part of wider work to build a culture of respect in surgery with the introduction of the RACS Diversity and Inclusion Plan and the RACS Indigenous Surgical Pathway Program. The RACS Diversity and Inclusion Plan works towards inclusive culture and leadership excellence, gender equity, inclusion of diversity groups, diverse representation on boards and in leadership roles, and benchmarking and reporting. The RACS Indigenous Surgical Pathway Program aims to increase the number of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander surgeons. For many years, surgical training has been underpinned by 9 core competencies: medical expertise, judgment and clinical decision making, technical expertise, professionalism, health advocacy, communication, collaboration and teamwork, leadership and management, scholarship and teaching. The college recently introduced cultural competence and cultural safety as the 10th core surgical competency, which is as central to surgical excellence as the existing 9 competencies. Let's explore how current fellows and aspiring surgeons at the Royal Darwin Hospital embody the core competencies in their daily lives. Meet Dr. Tara, health advocacy, communication. Growing up in Darwin, Dr. Tara developed an early insight into the health inequities of first Australians. She studied postgraduate medicine in South Australia and returned to Darwin as an intern. She was soon stepped up into a registrar role and was provided the support she needed to be accepted into the General Surgical Education and Training, SET program, in Victoria. Upon completion, she'll return as a consultant general surgeon. Having a dietetics background, she likes to keep fit and is a strong health advocate for her patients. Apart from spending a large part of her working day discussing patients with colleagues, talking to families and communicating with junior staff, she likes to chat, hands-free of course, on her drive home through heavy Melbourne traffic. She is a good communicator. Meet Dr. Kelvin, collaboration and teamwork, professionalism. Dr. Kelvin is a Warramai man. He studied medicine at the University of New South Wales and then went on to become the first Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander surgeon in Australia. Now, he works in a Awabakal country. Specialising in ENT surgery, Dr. Kelvin works closely with the community to understand their healthcare needs and helps deliver care to improve children's ear health. This shows good collaboration and teamwork. He takes the time to share his learnings and knowledge with the community and speaks widely at conferences about the health problems his countrymen face. He does this with well-respected professionalism. Meet Dr. Tash, medical expertise, leadership and management. Dr. Tash is a mother of 2 who for many years worked closely with First Australian families as a remote community nurse. She then went back to university to study medicine at the Northern Territory Flinders University Medical Program. Dr. Tash expressed an early interest in pursuing a career in surgery and entered the surgical stream for junior doctors, after which she accepted a junior surgical registrar role as the next step towards her future as a vascular surgeon. When she was a solo practitioner in community, she relied a lot on her own knowledge and experience and has recently sat for the General Surgical Sciences exam, both examples of her medical expertise. Dr. Tash not only manages her patients and their operations, but as a mother, she also juggles and looks after her family. Good management and leadership skills are a necessity here. Meet Dr. Richard, judgment and clinical decision making, cultural competence and cultural safety. Dr. Richard completed his surgical education and training program in Queensland. As part of his training, he came to Darwin for 6 months and loved it so much he returned with his wife and 3 sons as a trained general surgeon. He now chairs the Medical Advisory Committee at the Royal Darwin Hospital. During COVID-19, Dr. Richard realised that staff no longer had a haven for their breaks, as the hospital cafe was no longer accessible. Being aware that the well-being of the staff was critical, especially during this period, Dr. Richard helped ensure that staff still had access to a space for their rest and respite. This showed good judgement and decision-making. Also, during COVID-19, Dr. Richard provided 24/7 surgical cover for Numbulwar, Northern Territory, where he spent a lot of time understanding the culture and healthcare needs of the community better. This was an opportunity to spend time reflecting upon his cultural competence and cultural safety. And finally, meet Dr. Steph, scholarship and teaching, technical expertise. Dr. Steph started out in forensic science and then gave up the lab coat for the stethoscope. As a student, she did a clinical placement on Groot Island. She always planned to return to the top end and contribute in a more meaningful way once she had completed her surgical training in a bigger centre. She finished her surgical training in Victoria and headed back to the top end. Dr. Steph, who is both a scholar and a teacher, is passionate about surgical education. She likes to teach in interesting places using unique methods, like cooking. Also, being a dressmaker, her handiwork displays exemplary technical skills, which translates well to her work on the human body. There are many pathways to becoming a surgeon, and just as many ways to exemplify the core competencies that reflect our commitment to the community to deliver high-quality, patient-centred surgical care. What skills or attributes do you have that will make you a great surgeon? To learn more about the RACS Indigenous Surgical Pathway Program or to access surgical training resources, visit the following links.